What?
I think it's about time.
I can't take this.
Yeah. He's like, God damn.
Every actor who was on the scene with John Leguizamo has that look at one point on their face, like they're all tired and shit. Everybody gets that look.
Because we're seeing the scenes that the editor kept in, but how long did he ad lib?
Right.
Stuff that they's like, nope.
Hey everyone, I'm sure you heard by now, Double Toasted is heading out on tour, bringing you a night of comedy, games, and some interaction with the audience out there. And our New York show is coming up very soon, this Friday, September 10th. So you got to get your tickets now. Get your tickets by going over to doubletoasted.com or going over to X1 Entertainment and get tickets for that New York show or any of our upcoming live shows. Hey, we'll see you soon. Hey everyone, support our Patreon, which helps us to continue bringing you our live streams, videos, and podcasts while bringing you new content such as exclusive live streams and animated shorts. I need to let y'all know that the bad movie roast that we're about to bring to you, the roast that we're about to bring to you is being prepared by Raycon Earbuds over here. No, I'm laughing, but y'all know Raycon, man. And y'all think I'm just doing this for the money, and maybe I am, but I really do like their earbuds. I told you this before. There you have the different brands right here, the everyday earbuds, the fitness earbuds, the work earbuds right here. I have the everyday earbuds. Look at them. I mean, even Kevin Hart said, damn. Some good earbuds over there.
They got three categories.
He really does use them.
Yeah, man. No, here's the great thing about this, because listen, we're about to head over to New York on Friday. Mm-hmm. You're going to see me wearing my Raycon earbuds. Because, and I've been using this before for travel. Now, what I really like about these earbuds, and I'm being serious, you know, they tell you to talk about certain things, but I have about three different brands of earbuds.
Yeah.
And I've been listening to these, and I was like, well, how come this ain't run out yet? Uh-huh. I've actually just almost fallen asleep with these in my ears, man. Wake up in the morning just digging earbuds out.
Yeah.
Because for one, they last 32 hours. For another, they're very comfortable because they got these gel tips on the in right here. And something else that I like about these, they go inside your ear because you see the people looking like cyborgs
with the things dangling,
with the earbuds sticking out. And so listen, if any of y'all catch me at the airport or you catch me walking around New York or something, you're going to see me wearing these, because I'm being serious, I like these. And I recommend that you try them yourself, and you got nothing to lose, because for one thing, they have a 45-day money back guarantee. 45-day happiness guarantee with that. I'm going to get you a discount on this. Hey, go on over to buyraycon.com/toasted and save 15% on Raycons. Again, that is buyraycon.com/toasted and get yourself 15% off your purchase of some Raycon earbuds over there. Tell them Corey sent you. And once again, I want to thank Raycon Earbuds for approving and sponsoring this review that we're about to do. I got a lot of history with your boy Spawn.
Is that right?
I do. Now, a lot of y'all know Spawn out there. Let me go ahead and bring up the old funny book of Spawn over here. Oh, y'all know that's the creation of Todd McFarlane. It was such a phenomenal hit. Everybody loved the costume. Everybody loved the dark story behind them. Somebody said, you know what? They got to make a movie out of this. And when they did, somebody said, why they make a movie out of this? This didn't need to be done. Right.
Somebody said, wait.
Yeah. You know.
I was kidding. I was drunk when I said that.
Yeah.
No.
Slam. Yeah. You know, this was just, it was barely just fine as a comic. Now why they have to go and make a motion picture out of this thing over here? Yeah, people. This is one of the most notoriously bad movies. You go by just how many critics hated it, and also fans are split. But even if fans are split on Spawn, that how crazy they are, fanatic they are about this. Yeah. If they are not at least 95% on the same page on this, there's something wrong with that shit. So the fandom split. Most of the critics out there said, "Oh, you." This is a movie
not only known for being one of the worst movies of the 90s, but known for just being very notoriously 90s.
Oops.
Oh, shit. It's time
to go.
even that actor was like, man, fuck
yeah,
this.
He looked like his man.
Like, this is the best y'all can do.
And that Nicole Williams thing, when you need it on the set.
Nah.
Imagine a substance with the power to destroy humanity.
You've been violated, girly man.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
Fun fact.
Yeah, we were doing all right.
Yeah. You start doing them voices and shit.
Yeah. Yeah, just in case you don't know the story of Spawn. Spawn was once a man, a mere mortal like the rest of us, but a badass mere mortal by the name of Al Simmons. Al Simmons was cold-hearted, cold-blooded, but also one of the best mercenaries out there. And all you had to do was call him up to do a job because he said, you know what? I'm a professional. No matter who dies, no matter what happens, no matter what the stakes. If somebody calls me for a job, I get it done. Except that kind of attitude cost him his soul, and he was sent straight to hell. It took him hell to realize, whoa, shit, well, I just f***ed life up. But the devil said, man, you were so good at your job that I want you to lead my army for when we take over the world. And how are we going to do that? Well, the devil said, well, man, you know what? I went over to the White House, and I just made an agreement with one of the U.S. agents over there and said, you know what, take this virus and just spread it all around. And when you kill everybody, I'll show up. How that's supposed to solve anything, I don't know. I don't understand. I don't get it. Nobody loves Spawn for the story, I think.
I got to say, I felt confused reading the comic book. I felt confused watching this movie, and you just explain it as simply as possible, and I'm still like, what?
Yeah.
I'm like, but wait, but no, but
yeah.
Okay, never mind.
The devil, did y'all hear me? The devil went over to the U.S. government and made a contract with a weapons dealer over there and said, hey, I want you to take this virus and spread it around the world, because when you kill everybody, I can come in and do some shit. I don't know what that was supposed to accomplish. I spent all day trying to Da Vinci Code this shit to figure out what's going on. I still don't know what's happening. But as I said, no, that's me right now trying to understand this shit.
And I couldn't get my plan going until this one guy died.
Yes. Now, I don't want to bring him the whole shit, but this one of the first big disagreements I had with Martin back in the day. You really loved this movie back in the day.
I wouldn't say I loved it, but I did like it.
I remember you wrote a glow, because I remember, now this was stupid. This was dumb, but I remember Martin wrote this glowing review with Spawn, because he used to put up these reviews, and he did a glowing review with Spawn, and I just remember hating this movie when it came out. I remember reading his review, and I was like, well, this won't stand. I got to talk to this man. I went and talked to him, and we had this petty-ass argument. Well, it had this and had this. Well, I don't care. I liked it for this and that. Well, I think it's stupid. Martin's like, well, I don't. Well, bye.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, having to rewatch it again, man, you win big time.
How can that be?
I can only say this one thing about whatever I said back then that I stand by. I still like it better than the comic book.
You know that you are off to a bad start when the movie begins and they got to explain the movie to you before it even starts. Oh, they got to explain. They don't even know what's going on. They knew the audience would be confused.
Yeah.
Before the movie begins, they're giving you a big-ass long explanation of what's happening, and it don't help that that explanation looks like it's from a 90s CD-ROM game.
The battle between heaven and hell has waged eternal.
Like, shit, I'm out of this shit.
You're right. Out of nowhere, too.
You're right. And if you saw a giant army setting up, you'd be like, oh, shit, we about to get into it. But yeah, with those CD-ROM visual collages going on, you're like, stop.
People, this is just a bunch of stock images and video thrown into a blender, man.
Hell has waged.
That dub is from a wedding video.
Yeah.
The devil Malbolgia has sent a lieutenant to Earth to recruit men who will turn the world into a place of death.
This is shit that we should be seeing in the movie.
This kind of thing happens when the movie's done and the producers go, nobody's going to understand.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
Put a prologue on. That's, explain it.
That's exactly it.
Yeah.
You explaining shit that people film. This is what directors and screenwriters are for. Not narrators.
But that's when the studio jumps in and goes, all right, get your B-roll. Yeah. We don't have any B-roll. Yeah. Get something together.
Because I know if I don't understand this shit, they ain't going to understand this shit.
And power. A place that will provide enough souls to complete his army.
I love this too, because even when you're looking at it, like, it don't make sense. Like, look at the images are more confusing than me. Look at this.
That on Earth, the devil Malbolgia has sent a lieutenant to Earth.
A clown?
A clown? A lieutenant?
A goddamn juggalo? I saw this dude at an insane clown posse concert. Yeah.
Someone who can lead his hordes to the gates of heaven and burn them down.
People in
So the devil comes, hires a lieutenant so that he can find somebody to lead people to heaven?
To burn heaven down.
Oh, okay.
Didn't you hear anything I said? That's what we need the virus for. Did you not hear? And people there, so much fire.
So very much
so,
fire.
So much fire.
Oh, no, it's all fire and doves.
So much. It's like... It's, I thought some people, like, people looking at it, they think it's a Prince video.
Right. The dove is like, what the f*** am I doing here?
Why am I in this?
People, there, so much fire, so much goddamn fire. There's, even hell don't have this much fire in it as much as this movie does. And because the special effects people, it's like they went online and bought every fire filter and every fire footage that they could find and put it in this movie right here. And I'm gonna tell y'all something, that flaming colon that you see right there, you're gonna see that 100 more times
in the
movie. That flaming colon is another character almost. Whatever they paid for that flaming spiral colon right there, they got the money's worth out of it, man. Shit, they must have paid $1,000 for that. Use that shit. People, they start out as an action film, and because it's Michael J. White, because, you know, they ain't really doing that much yet, and it's because it's generic. This is the only time I would say generic as is good.
Right.
Because I can understand
keep it simple, right?
Yeah. Anytime you, in this case, I'll take generic any day. Generic, I can understand. Yeah. So this starts out as a generic-ass action movie, and it's not even, when I say generic for any other movie, it would not be good for here. This is a relief. When you're a guard, don't ever take a smoke break.
Yeah, right, no.
Don't even hear a noise.
Don't even turn your back towards the door when you're a guard.
When you're a guard in a movie, don't ever take a smoke break.
You take that cigarette's your ass.
Because either the hero or the villain will come behind you and choke your ass out.
Choke you out or knock you out.
Knock you out, karate chop your neck or something. Always do your job. Put that cigarette down and you go home. Because you are all Michael J. White will come in and kick the shit out of you. I'm looking at this, I'm like, is he shooting with bullets or firecrackers? If you look at this,
and all the guys are right there, he's like, you're shooting up the computers more than you are the
people. I don't see one bullet in one of them Koreans over there, but I see a whole bunch of sparklers going off.
They're playing charades and shit.
It's like
running my back.
It's like he came in and lit a brick of black cash and threw that shit in the room. They're like,
They jump because of the fireworks.
They jump because of the firecrackers. They like that asshole friend of yours on 4th of July. They light up a bunch of firecrackers and throw them at your ass. And I ain't seen one bullet, but I saw them goddamn firecrackers going off.
Go play.
You see that? It is an interesting setup for the movie. I say it's generic, but they do something kind of cool here.
Yeah, that pocket missile.
Well, the missile, but what they do here is that they so, you know, like I said, Al's a mercenary. When he comes in, when he takes out his target, he also kills a lot of innocent civilians. Yeah. He don't give a f-. And it's one of those few movies where they set up the hero doing something bad. Mm-hmm. Like, this is the guy that we're supposed to be rooting for, and he kills all kind of women in the beginning. Don't
Yeah. That was so bad that when the thing blew up, like somebody would have been like, okay, that was a simulation. That's what it would look like if you actually did the shit.
You're right, but it's the best special effect in the movie.
It's, yeah. So that's him playing, he's playing PlayStation right now. I can't feel too bad for the, at least not for the target, man, because that dude came out. That dude came out when the guy came out that he hit, that guy looked like he was happy to get blown up. Hello, yay. I'm ready. Look at that. Hey, right here, I'm ready. He looked, that fool looks straight at the camera.
Right. Hey, right here, man. Come on.
Is that you, Spawn? I'm ready. But also, while you're watching that scene, first of all, you got the guy waving, just telling him, over here, over here. But then, you know, before you can feel sympathy for anybody, you're getting distracted by saying, who the f*** is this guy?
Yeah.
Okay, people, I know in the comics this is a character. It's a character named Cogliostro.
Cogliostro.
Cogliostro. Cogliostro. But you know this guy right here. You're asking like, who the f- is that guy? And as soon as you ask yourself that question, man, you're like, you know what? I'm sorry I asked.
Like him, I killed in the name of good. But the violence of my life pulled my soul.
What's your name, man? You know, this is not a long answer, right? Yeah,
don't worry about it. Don't ask. You're only gonna be sorry with the answer.
Yeah,
it's an epic story. Yeah. It's a down. Yeah. Let me tell you.
But I like me. Men are the ones who create evil on earth.
This is shit they took from the movie,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, for real.
These people just looking
even
around.
What are you talking about?
It is the choices they make that enslave their souls. Is the test.
And that flaming coal in his back. I told y'all. That's twice in 6 minutes that they played the flaming colon right there.
I feel like if you interrupted him while he was doing his spiel, but no, but what about... Oh, he would just rewind and start over the beginning.
Now I have to start all over again.
You made me lose my concentration, as I was saying. Where was I?
Is everyone paying attention?
Like him, I was once a warrior. He was just walking out.
Yeah, fuck it, man. Never mind, man.
I too fought the armies of hell.
Doors are locked.
Hello? Anyway. And I lost many times, but I prevailed.
It doesn't make any sense.
It don't make no sense.
No, it doesn't.
It's just words.
He's got some powers. But they never explain how this fool goes from country to country. I don't give a f- how many powers he's got. He's still homeless. They show you in the movie he's homeless. Oh, he ain't got no money. The possessions he's got is that coat and that hat. And whatever's underneath there.
He teleports through the colon fire hole.
No, he don't. Cause
he just stops right?
Because he don't work for Satan no more.
Oh.
So what? Even that shit don't make no sense.
See, I can't even believe he said some shit like that.
Yeah.
Well, he does seem to have some teleportation powers.
Well, I guess so. And if he does that, they should explain that in the movie, first of all.
They don't explain
shit in it.
They over-explain the things you don't care about.
Yeah.
The stuff you want to know, they don't say shit about.
Yeah, How about talking about the homeless teleporting man? And also, can we bring attention to that nobody notices when the homeless man just walks out in public in broad daylight, glowing green? Just out there in the broad daylight looking like Slimer or something.
What the?
Yeah.
It's his aura, Coleman.
Well, something like that car that went by. Did you not see that shit?
Don't worry, honey. He on that shit.
Yeah.
Makes you glow.
You not see that man come out that alley glowing green like that? They are very proud of some of the people that they got here. When the movie starts, they let you know they are very proud of some of the people that they have in this movie. You can tell because they just... Like, look, this ain't the best shot movie in some cases, but... They made sure to get that dramatic turn for the actors that they are very proud of.
Bosnia, France, Moscow, and the United States are joining together to denounce this blatant act.
Simmons is the best.
Did y'all see that dramatic turn right there?
Yeah.
It's almost like they said, ladies and gentlemen, Martin Sheen.
You know what's funny about that one, sir? Earlier, he was like, "Man, we can't get him to grow a beard, but we got a whole bottle of shoe polish for Martin Sheen there and his beard." God
well,
damn.
Well, it's not him that they want to grow the beard, but
no, I'm saying they got a lot of shoe polish
well,
for us.
Yeah. Well, that's why the half the budget for this went on like coloring his hair black,
and it's just so. Obvious.
It's so
it's
obvious.
Distracting.
It is. Yeah. even Spawn didn't get a dramatic shot like this. Martin Sheen.
That's right.
When you see that they got Martin Sheen in here, you know Martin Sheen, boy. I mean, he's done so much in cinema. Mr. Apocalypse Now. You know, they get him in this, and at first you start thinking, man, well, this right here, this is legit then. Okay, we were off to a rocky start, but I mean, with A-list actors like this, all right, Spawn, you're doing something. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, I haven't seen every movie that Martin Sheen has been in. I have not seen every TV show. I haven't seen every play that Martin Sheen has been in. But I'm going to tell you that Martin Sheen did not get to the position he is today by acting like this because
okay, I was gonna say
because you look at this when you see him turn around as Martin Sheen, you like, okay, well shit, that didn't last long.
We made a deal, when
engineering a biological weapon is an exact science. You want it done right, you do it my way.
Okay, Martin Sheen did get to where he is today by doing what we just saw right there. Oh, and let's just not overlook the fact that he is talking to a clown smoking a cigar?
We don't know yet.
Yeah,
see? He's in silhouette.
Okay, you're right. Fair point.
Be fair.
All right. You don't know it's a clown. All you know is it's a fat guy with a cigar.
If you haven't had enough of fire montages, fire opening credits, or explanations with fire, well, let me show y'all what I got here, boy. I got now we have the fire wipe.
Oh, wow.
I told you, they use the f*** out those fire effects, man. Oh, but if you are tired of fire, they do have, when it comes to wipes, man.
Do you have a wipes montage?
Yeah, yes, wipes.
Man, if you're getting tired of the fire and getting tired of the fire wipes, at least when it comes to wipes, they got variety in there. Don't want a fire wipe? How about this nice door wipe right here?
Oh, no, they didn't.
The transition. Hey,
you want to say that again?
Yes. Oh.
You know what?
It's the 90s.
No, that's something like me and my brother would make movies in junior high, and we'd be like, check out the you just did, man.
Because you didn't know any better because you were kids, because you used every effect and filter that you could find.
That they had at Keelan Junior High School, right. So this is a real movie that came out years later. No, man.
Back to Martin Sheen here, man. You know that he's up to no good. His name is in the movie, his name is Jason Lin.
Wynn.
Well, I'm sorry, I knew I'd get his name wrong. Not that it even matters, but his name is Jason Wynn. I told you that he was he works for the government. Him and his side chick named Priest. You know that those two up there, man, they are up to no good when you see them, man. They all decked out in leather, got too much makeup on.
Yeah, they're like Boris and Natasha.
Yeah, don't even try to hide them. Yeah, and like I said, don't even. More worried about being sexy than being covert.
I will send whoever, wherever I choose.
Ain't even trying to hide. Not trying to hide her ass. Not trying to hide that gun.
Right.
Trying to put it all up in there. And know everybody looking at that ass. Shit, even in the movie, man. There's a scene where Martin Sheen and the cameraman are looking at her ass. Who's looking at my ass?
That's the cameraman tripping over something.
Yeah, she heard it. Yeah. Hey, I thought you would follow me. That's Melinda Clark, by the way. Who got ass? I tell you that much. I like the way he got up and like, shit, I'm all right. I see that ass.
Yeah, exactly. Back to life.
Yeah, man. They are so villainous. if you can be like over villainous.
Yeah.
That's them, man.
They do everything but cackle and wring their hands.
And they even kind of do that at one part. But, I mean, you know these fools are villainous because, first of all, they're overdoing it. Even if you were like another villain that was working with them, you'd be like, man, y'all pull this shit back some. Like when they bring somebody in, to have a meeting. In the middle of the meeting, they're so villainous that they got to play with scorpions and spiders.
Oh, sick.
Come on, son, this is top priority.
Yes. He's looking left out. He's like, shit, if y'all told me to bring your pet to work, that would have brought my hamster. Right.
That's why you got to laugh that he's suddenly like, man, if I knew y'all were dairy, I wouldn't have been working for you.
Hell right. Yeah.
Like, come on.
She's like, I did everything to show you that we were. Yeah. I mean, I even wore the dirty dress, the evil one.
Yeah, it's like, my man constantly smokes cigars. The bitch don't have a gun. They in the office playing with spiders and scorpions. And then you go, hey, wait a minute. Y'all evil. y'all should have told me, man. If the cigar and the black hair and everything to give it away, listen, y'all, I don't see how y'all cannot see that this man is villainous. And this truly is Al's fault. The man sits up there. He monologues like villains do. Mm-hmm. He sits up there, monologues his whole plan while smoking a cigar, and at the end of it, doesn't laugh. He actually says, ha, 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 ha.
Now we have the only vaccine. Anyone who refuses to join my consortium won't be around to argue.
Yo, this is back. Also, like, the camera's dead on her, and he's going.
And she's like, "Yeah, she's like, pull it back a little bit, man. Goddamn,
yeah, take it down a notch."
It sounded like they made him come back in just to record that extra laugh. Yeah.
He probably did.
Yeah, he probably did.
Look at her face, though. She's even like, "Yeah, I can't. That's enough. Like, I'm gonna keep smiling so you don't get mad."
She's like, "I've heard about this plan." Every time I walk in a room,
this is the fourth time.
I just wanted to do it so I don't have to hear about it anymore.
God damn it. Okay.
Keep smiling, though.
Hey, he pays me. Yeah. At least he ain't touching my ass like he usually does.
Right. You have to play some scorpions.
That's how you laugh.
And it's off screen, too. That's fake.
They've been playing with scorpions and monologuing, smoking cigars, wearing lingerie with weapons on it and shit. And then he gonna be surprised when they betray this.
No,
he gonna mission. They end up being there before. He like, hey, what y'all doing here?
What y'all doing here?
What? Well,
I do believe he's catching on.
That's like, damn, right? When you think Karens could get any worse.
Right.
Shit, they don't call the police on black man anymore. Like, shit, I'll take care of this myself.
Right. I love it. He's still like, no, but seriously, what's going on?
Yeah.
He's still not getting it.
I believe he's catching on.
Will this help me do the mission better?
And even then, he's kind of like, he is like, what are you doing?
What is this?
And at that moment, they're just like, you know what? You... That's his woman.
Yeah.
He gets there ahead of him, and they get tired of his ass. So they squirt his ass down with them chemical Nerf guns, and then they light his ass up.
And walk away quick
and
too.
And he's still looking confused. But wait a minute.
I know.
Get it, y'all.
All I said is I need a light.
Look, he's still confused.
Hey, wait a minute, y'all.
And one that can't do nothing for your crisp ass now.
Y'all coming back, right?
He's burned alive. He's burned dead. And after that, I told y'all, boy, he was such a bad guy in life that he sent straight to hell. And how do you think he got there?
Layman Coleman!
I believe that was the 50th time that they did that. Oh, and by the way, that reverse shot, they got their money's worth out of that, too.
That's right.
He wakes up 5 years later, not knowing who he is or where he is. All he, you know, what he does, he wakes up as a homeless man in a place called Rat City.
Okay.
And looking like a California raisin when he comes back. And Rat City's crazy, man, because I know
Rat City.
Are there rats?
Well, I mean, there's rats. It's mostly just homeless people. It's like under the freeways at Austin.
Yes. Yes, it is. with less tents and more dumpsters, because Rat City is a place where, now y'all thought, you thought Austin and LA had a homeless problem? We do, but at least we allow people to kind of live in tents. But apparently in Rat City, don't bring them temps up in here. Y'all live in dumpsters. There are whole families, kids, parents living, not in boxes, not in tents, but straight up dumpsters.
Holy place. All are welcome here.
Holy place, more like holy shit. What you talking about? Holy.
All are welcome here.
Yeah.
They just don't want to come.
Yeah. Right. It's a holy place.
Yeah.
What was the name of it again? Yeah. Rat City.
Yeah, all are welcome here because nobody wants to be in that motherfucker. That's why. Is it holy? This is the nastiest goddamn church I've been in then. But then your boy enters the movie and it kind of turns into...
This is the same movie.
You know what? It might as well be.
It's not, but he's the same guy, just in a fat suit.
It might as well be the same movie.
I love it. Oh, I lied.
It might as well be the same movie because
he brought that same energy.
Did he?
Yeah, people. Oh, people.
Yeah, it's like some of the same shtick too.
This first they had an action film, then they had a dark fantasy. Now, thanks to your boy, they just started. They said, "Fuck it, you know what? Let's just make a gross out comedy."
Easy with that face, I'm eating. I'm not eating. Oops! Look at that. Get marks.
And this is like.
Get away from me.
It's like, goddamn.
Yeah, you're right. Same shtick.
It's the same thing, man.
At least the other one had a catchy tune.
Get away from me.
That's the audience watching. Stop. Yeah. Stop. It's like, man, are we even watching this? Are we watching the same movie? Because when they bring him on, this is a character called Violator. And you read the comics. Can you tell me why he's a clown?
Because clowns are interesting to draw.
Okay, so in other words,
I read the comics.
There's no reason.
There's no reason for him to be a clown.
Funny, he's our man. If you can't kill him, no one can. Yay, funny. S to the P to the A to the one.
What the f is happening?
You're not entertained
at this point. I'm just confused. I remember, this is why I hated the movie back in the day. I was like, because the whole time I'm watching this, John Leguizamo is in a, he's in a completely different movie.
Funny, he's our man, if you can't kill him, no.
It's like, out of all the shit that we've seen, they might be different movies, but they're kind of jiving in one particular spot. They're all dark, they're all kind of gritty, they're all action-oriented. What the f*** is going on with this man here?
Yay, funny.
Shut the f*** up. I have no idea what is happening right there.
Well, a glowing review, huh?
And he wonders why I was going so hard on him back in the day.
You showed me some shit like this. I'm like, what the f*** is wrong with you, man?
Spawn somebody from hell and, you know, you think if you're some supernatural creature, you kind of be low-key. Spawn some, mate. I crash parties.
Who are you?
You sent me to hell, Jason. I'm here to return the favor.
Well, you were there to kill him. I think while you have his neck, you take the opportunity to maybe snap that shit.
A couple more pounds of pressure, it would have been done.
That's it.
Took him a while, too. Like, could you be more specific about who you are?
I love it, too. Because a supernatural creature ain't supposed to be showing up in the middle of parties and everything, but they wanted their, you talk about being derivative of Batman, they wanted their Batman moment.
Yep.
Fake ass glass.
Oh my god.
Damn, ain't none of that glass look, none of that wood, none of that glass.
Oh shit. Yeah. That wood disappeared.
Shit, yeah, it evaporated.
Yeah, he did. He didn't even go down.
Out of all the bad things in this movie, I'm gonna go out on a limb and I'm gonna say that John Leguizamo as the clown Violator is definitely the worst.
Well, every time somebody farts, a demon catches a wings. Oops, twins.
You know,
he's thinking about the motherfucker.
Damn. I mean, that's just making me mad when I was watching. I was like, just stop.
Well, those are some of the only genuine reactions in the whole movie.
Oh, yeah.
You're farting jokes and shit?
Yeah, no, no. When he does that and Spawn is just like, man, could you please just get away from me?
For real. Seriously. I've asked you several times.
Like, he just brings... Michael J. White is actually... He's actually all right in some parts, but... But then, there, you know, he just... John Leguizamo just brings him down, man.
Brings his mood down.
Hey,
oh, come on.
He's feeling the scenes like, hey, what's going on in here? Oh, man, never mind.
It feels like John Leguizamo's ad-libbing is just putting Michael J. White in pain. Not Spawn, but the actor, Michael J. White. He's just like, I can't take this shit no more. There were moments where he was doing well, but when he's with him, he looks like... Michael J. White, when he's with John Leguizamo, he spends the movie looking like he just has to take a shit because he's getting so tired of him.
You're pushing up daisies. You're in permanent nap time. Your fertilizer. Hey, is any of this sinking in?
He's like, stop. Just please, God.
He's like, just kill me.
For the love of baby Jesus, please stop.
Are you they cut or something, man? Jesus Christ.
Somebody, please. Recast.
This shit ain't funny no more.
He makes no sense. Like I said, I don't understand why he's a clown, first of all. We've already established that. But the other thing is that, you know, when I was talking about Aladdin in the mask, he just doesn't work for this movie because, you know, the movie is dark, it's gritty, it's trying to, on the verge of being rated R. And he comes in, and it's a cartoon. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm complete with cartoon humor and cartoon sound effects.
What?
Like, they looked like, what the f*** is this? He's like, did you see this?
Yeah, right. Right. Oh, fake ass Beetlejuice.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah. Some fake ass Beetlejuice shit.
Yeah, it wasn't just me who saw that, right?
Yeah. Yeah, and like I was saying, man, they start getting like to the sound effects of cartoons in this. He was like, God damn. He's like, y'all thought I was bad.
He said, God damn.
Shit.
Does wonders for my asthma.
You know, none of these jokes in here. There's not one joke in here that he does that works. And like I said, man, well, the problem is that because they thought that they were going to be rated R at one time, they start coming in with all these nasty jokes, and nasty jokes just don't work at all, man, much less just being nasty for just being nasty's reason or sake.
Hey, Wanda, what do you think about a little head, huh?
Shut the f*** up,
oh,
man.
Jesus Christ.
Well, that's not appropriate.
Apparently his humor in those lines, for him, they get hoes.
I can't take this.
Yeah, he's like, God damn.
Every actor who was on the scene with John Leguizamo has that look at one point on their face, like they're all tired and shit. Everybody gets that look.
Because we're seeing the scenes that the editor kept in, but how long did he ad-lib?
Right.
Stuff that they's like, nope.
On the fifth or sixth take, you know, he's like, Jesus Christ.
Every actor, there's not one actor that was in a scene where that at some point does not get that look like, I'm going to kill this motherfucker. Only thing worse than I could say John Leguizamo in the movie is probably the effects, man. These effects are
nothing special about them.
Shit, isn't it? There's an effect. We feel it. It's a bad effect.
You never see a movie that where every effect is terrible. like sometimes they, you know, they get it right just by accident.
Right, I'm mistaken.
Or this is okay. They save their budget to get this one thing right. Not here.
And they are just so proud of hell in this movie. Hell in this movie looks like a computer game from 1993.
It's not
there.
It's not.
I must choose to murder Wynn and release the virus.
They can't even make his mouth move, y'all.
He sound like Dr. Claw from the cartoon.
Yeah. They try to say like, no, we wanted the audience to believe that hell was speaking through him. It's like, no. He just couldn't animate his mouth.
Y'all didn't have no money is what it was. And boy, they are so proud of these bad effects that they have here that they
triple down.
By the end of the movie, they go big. They just go all out at the end of the movie. Hell is a place where people just stand on fake-looking rocks and just go, hey,
just, they look like just a bunch jiggle. Of little little army man.
Just,
little
just jiggling. Just like, ain't not even animated. Just out there, just yeah. And this.
If you won't lead my army, then you.
He's like, what the.
He's like, who's talking? He's behind like, you? Or?
He's like, y'all got to be kidding.
Y'all bullshitting, right?
He's like, is anybody going to put a control in my hand right now? So, this shit, what this is, this rivals Asylum.
I know.
This was back in the 90s.
That's exactly what I kept thinking the whole time.
Even for the 90s, this is up there with the Asylum. Oh. You want me to remind you what you said in your review?
I do. Oh. I'd love to hear it. Pull it up.
That's the line that got me. He said, in hell, hell has never looked so beautiful.
Oh, I remember that from back in the day when you said
that. Martin was on that shit. He was like, man, I have to champion this, defend this movie from all these people. I was like, there's something going on at the time.
Hell never looked so beautiful when I was high on these mushrooms.
Yeah, you must have been on some LSD or something.
It was midnight. It was late.
Nah, man. Hey, it's past midnight right now. I'm looking at this shit, okay? So
I can only say that the resolution back in 1997 isn't what we see now.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
This,
no.
This was... No. This
come on, Billy. Come on. This, man, I help you out.
What are you doing for me later?
I'm gonna get you, bitch.
I'll get you, bitch.
Don't even get me started on that cape.
On a cape.
They proud of that
you
cape.
It's going through Martin Sheen.
And what can this cape do? I don't know. Whatever we need it to do. Sometimes it pops out and goes away. Sometimes it can make him turn invisible. It turns into a motorcycle.
Oh, he ain't lying. I'll show you this, man. Because, I mean, listen. Because the only parts that cape pops up on is at nighttime. And people, this is a... don't get me started on this cape. This is a dark, not just gritty, but grimy film at times.
Yeah.
You know, at especially at nighttime. But every time that cape flows out, it is the brightest, most flattest thing on the screen when that shit pops out.
Hey, man.
I look like some Kool-Aid.
Yeah. Ocean Spray cranberry.
That Kool-Aid cape. Yeah. Ocean Spray. Yeah.
So you could have flown away this whole time. All right.
Yeah, but I didn't feel like
that shit. Wow, cranberry juice. That just looked like
Ocean Spray, man.
Ocean Spray.
Yo, yeah, I mean, Ocean Spray. Yeah,
Spray.
I
mean, Ocean Spray. I do like the makeup on Spawn. I even like the makeup on. I think they did a good job with the makeup on Violator, on John Leguizamo. I actually like the makeup job on him. If the character makes sense, it would have been cool. If he wasn't annoying, it would have been cool.
The thing I couldn't tell is if he was wearing prosthetics or that's his real teeth.
No. John Leguizamo got those sharp teeth. Oh, sharp man, teeth ain't that bad.
Yeah. I was going to say, fun fact, those are his real teeth.
Oh, you know what? Okay, so talking about the effects and talking about people being dedicated to this, two things I can say about John Leguizamo in here. I do like his effects in this, and I gotta say, hey, he was committed to the role, man.
That's
way
all I'm saying.
Way more committed than anybody should be.
That's all I'm saying. He was committed.
I don't know why this has been a theme in the last couple of weeks, but there's a scene with maggots, live maggots. And he and you can look this up, like he ate maggots for this role.
I hate anchovies.
Gross.
Yeah, like he chewed, though. Like he ate maggots.
Maggots are grub worms.
No, they call them wax maggots, which I don't know what distinction that
is. Yeah, they're not fly maggots or anything. Like, I think the maggots you feed to like reptiles and stuff like that.
You gonna eat some?
Hell no.
Hell no.
Well, not if you prepare them first, maybe. You know, maybe fry them up for me, I might. So there's a scene when Violator turns into this big creature. For anybody reads the comics, and the only reason why is because I even think this is for the comics. It's just because, well, a giant creature looks cool to draw like this. But in the movie, see that devil, or his name is Malboja or something in the movie.
Yeah, you got it right.
He looks terrible in the movie, but the Violator monster actually looks kind of cool.
Violator!
Now, I thought that that creature looked cool because, first of all, this is the 90s. So that for the 90s, that wasn't too bad. But also, there's some other parts here where when they do close-ups, because I was reading about how some, I think I even talked to one of the effects artists that worked on this. But there's a part where when they do close-ups with the Violator Monster, I think it's practical effects. And I thought, all right, that was kind of cool that they used practical effects on that. And since they had that in that scene, Spawn's armor change for the 90s, I didn't think that that was that bad either. Man, we're about to wrap this up, but I'm going to tell you one of the funniest and saddest moments in the movie is near the end. Okay, they have a fight. They defeat the bad guys. You saw some of it in the living room right there and everything. But Spawn, he thought that he had lost his dog named Spaz. And I think Spaz is named after one of the effects guys in the movies because you see a Spaz in the credits.
Yeah.
While the credits are actually spazzing out at that time. But there's a moment where Spawn, he looks over at this kid. I think his name is Nick. That's one of the kids living in Rat Alley.
Rat City.
Rat City. Rat City.
Soup City.
Rat Town.
Rat City on BET. He tells his kid, he says, hey man, if you find my dog Spaz, I don't care if he's dead or alive. Hey, just bring him back to me.
I want you to return Spaz to me. No matter how you find him, understand?
And the thing is, the kid keeps his promise, man. Kid goes back over to Rat City, looks for the dog, and this is across town. All right, Rat City ain't nowhere near this gated community that this family lives in. Mm-hmm. But that dog knows how to get home from all the way from Rat City, a place that he'd never been before. And the kid trying to keep Spawn's promise, the kid follows him and delivers him back to the family.
Spaz! Hey!
I'm looking at, hey.
I followed him here.
Thanks, kid.
You're like, you got it, Spawn. Anything for you. Now, the sad thing about this is that the dad that smacked him, he knew this dad was going to get something. We clearly see that the kid is orphaned because his dad died in the movie when Violator threw him against a wall. So, and then you know, when they pull that blanket over your head in the movie, you're gone.
You're done.
Yeah, you're gone. Now, you would think that with this kid, not only delivering his promise to Spawn, but not having a home, not having a dad, a kid that's living in a dumpster in something called Rat City, you would think that Spawn would be like talking to his ex-wife and his best friend saying, you know, this little lad right here, he has no home, he has no family, and he brought my dog back. You would think that he would say he needs a family. I was expecting this to have an end where they were like, oh, well, you know what? You'll live with us now, and we'll love you like one of our own. And they said, shit, you better take your little ass back to Rat Alley. They sent his ass back.
Oh, man.
That fool is back at Rat Alley at the end. and take that damn dog with you, too.
Get your stinking ass.
Him and Spaz, send back to Rat City at the end.
Well, I mean, he's lucky that the family weren't like, and by the way, that's our dog.
Well, it was almost like they said, you know, like, hey, we never liked that dog anyway. That was Al's dog. You and that damn dog, get out of here. Both y'all go back to Rat City, eat a goddamn rotten maggot sandwich.
Yeah, exactly.
They don't even tempt to like take this kid in.
All right, you know how to get there on the bus, right?
Well, and that kid got a sad ass walk to, like, well, back to Rat City. Hey, yeah, what's up, man? I'm back. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah. Yeah.
Welcome back, young blood.
You started that shit when you left, right? Yeah, you back. Man, I'm gonna leave all you motherfuckers in the dust.
He's bums.
Yeah, he's already shaking hands like he had a bet. And he's like, well, you win. They said no. Yeah, I'm back. Hey, what you doing back so soon?
Fuck you, man.
Yeah, well, you said you found that dog, that you was gonna be living a good life. Yeah, look at your little ass there. Yeah. Look at your little bitch ass there.
I know about Tyrone. He just visited, right?
Yeah, Spawn 2. Welcome to Rat City, bitch. Welcome home.
I got to say, it was so bad, I couldn't even get mad. I was just so much of it. I was just like, wow, this is so bad. This is so, so bad.
So what's your rating? Do you guys rate
it? Oh, man.
Oh, 5 stars.
Yeah, of course.
I stand by my old review.
Because of John Leguizamo, man, because of how just how annoying and then nasty and uncomfortable he was. No, that's a man, this movie was
you got like so that motherfucker in that movie. Didn't
no,
you?
I hated it
not
back
a low
then.
Rental.
Yeah, no.
Oh no,
no.
Low matinee.
No. A low you
matinee.
No, I like I said, man, I really want to respect this movie because I do. I'm 100% behind what they were trying to do. You know, like I said, this is before Blade, man, and I bears repeating. I really appreciate that they made a black movie. A black lead in a movie without having to cater to what they think is black, you know, what black demographics, like making a soundtrack with all hip hop on it. Yeah. There's no hip hop on this at all. This is all electronic and rock soundtracks, and I think it's one of the best soundtracks of the 90s, man, as far as movies go. I have a lot of admiration for what they were trying to do, but the execution of this is so annoying. Not bad, annoying. Y'all gotta say you on this, man. It got on my nerves in some parts. Even the director, he's done some commentary. I think on the CD, on the DVD, director's commentary, he opens this up saying, yep, I'm the one to blame.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
okay.
It's all my fault.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that's very big of him. I know Michael Jai White has been like, I have never said this was a good movie. It's not on tape. It's not recorded anywhere. Me saying that, I dare you to find where I said Spawn was a good movie.